Round one, game two on the draw, and this is it's slow, but it also has enslave in it. It has mana, it has enslave. I'm inclined not to mulligan it. See, there you go. That's all I need. Yeah. I guess, I mean, it wasn't an exciting hand, but you don't ship a hand that's got full of mana, and you're bombing it, right? Right? If you, conceivably, if you expect your opponent's deck to be fast enough to, just kill you before you get everything online. But this is not the case. It seems that my opponent has sided into Wayfarer. At least I hope he sided into Wayfarer. Oh dear. Yeah, well, maybe he's sided into Wayfarer here, in expectation of me to have a super aggressive start out of the gates just like last game, but it was not to be. So we're gonna run out Pierce Strider here. If my opponent wants to trade Ogre Resistor for Pierce Strider, I'm more than happy with that. I'd rather lose Pierce Strider than Dross Ripper, which was gonna offer me the option to pump later on. And also, I don't want to let Ogre Resistor through, even though I mean I could have conceivably played out Dross Ripper, let Ogre Resistor come through, and then leave mana up, and then I've threatened to pump, but actually Grim Affliction, that kind of random shenanigans. I'd rather just do the trading and not losing the life. All right, so I'm gonna take four here, but it seems like good value. A little two for one, and it's gonna cost me a bit of life, but it's perfectly acceptable. Yeah, we're just gonna run out Dross Ripper here, and then again offer the trade with Ogre Resistor. The beauty of playing Hill Giants. Hopefully, Ogre Resistor. Well, if I trade with Ogre Resistor, what do I care? As long as they're it. Well, if there is a trick that keeps Ogre Resistor alive, it's only an Ogre Resistor. All right, and Eraser Hippogriff. Nice. So I can certainly race the Razor Hippogriff with my ELD Flameborn Viren. It's gonna be play the 6/4, and yeah, get there. Because next turn, I've got plenty of options. If he plays something, all right, worth enslaving. Flameborn Viren will not get there after all. Sad. Still, I'm better to use all my mana. And Gataxian Probe, yeah, I think it's worth paying 2 life to have a looky looky. All right, I'm gonna go print screen, open up Paint, which you can't see, but yeah, copy and paste it into Paint, so that I don't have to write it down or memorize it. It also keeps the pictures there. Utterly random, my opponent's saying. I beg to differ. All right, so I'm finished. Ah, Nathosaur. So if I play out Nathosaur, I'm gonna take more damage, but I get the beat train going. Yeah, I think I can afford to. Well, I don't know if I can afford to go down to 7, but I'm gonna do it anyways. Because once I get the beats coming, they're just not gonna stop. Yeah, Shrine of Loyal Legions, might stop me until I get an artifact online, I guess. But it's gonna be a little bit too slow the race. I could see myself enslaving the Razor Hippogriff here. Certainly, help me win the race much faster. And a Forest Walker is not very exciting. So, if I enslave the Razor Hippogriff, well, I've still got Go for the Throat. Blind Zealot gets him for 2. But enslave, yeah, enslave is 4 a turn. That's a lot. Let's bash first. So if I'm dealing 5 and then 9 every turn after that, gee, that makes my opponent very nearly dead. Let's just enslave this guy. There shouldn't, yeah, there's not many random artifact mythic bombs that will stop the bleeding here. Shrine of Loyal Legions can put chump blockers in front of Nathosaur for a while. Well, and if I see another artifact, I can give it trample. All right, take one. Yeah. All right. And blind zealot should help me. I don't know. If my opponent does play, say, Worm Coil Engine, that could be bad. Worm Coil Engine, yeah, would get him life. I guess Razor Hippogriff still gets him for four. Then against, yeah, okay. I can make Worm Coil Engine a 4/4. Can I still outrace it? Nearly. I guess the thing is that Worm Coil Engine wouldn't be able to attack me because yeah, Blind Zealot would attack back and kill it. All right, we're looking good here. So can surely kill my opponent a range of ways here. So if he sacrifices Shrine of Loyal Legions, he makes tokens. Palladium Mirror gives Nathasaur Trample, so that might kill him this turn. Let's see. He makes three tokens. He puts one token on Blind Zealot, Blister Stick, and a token on Nathasaur. Nathasaur tramples for three. Razor Hippogriff hits for three, puts him to one, and then he dies to Razor. Well, actually, no. Okay, Palladium Mirror plus removal spell. Palladium Mirror plus removal spell kills him this turn. Okay, let's give that a crack. And then I've still got Go for the Throat backup. So I want to, I don't know, kill a token. I'll see where his blocks go first. Yeah, okay. It doesn't matter. I'm just gonna Grim Affliction. Grim Affliction, the Blister Stick, sacrifice Palladium Mirror, and kill my opponent. Boom. Doesn't matter where you stick your blocks, you die. Wait. Yeah. Alrighty, on to the next round. Good times.